haven't seen an Opus camper trailer before, you're in for a treat. Anybody know what's unique about the Opus camper? Inflatable. Correct. No steel poles anywhere here. So this camper here is our OP4, which is our flagship product. This camper here is those two campers there. Same camper, blue. We're going to do a full setup of this, and we're going to pack it back down again. So the only difference between what you're going to see today and what you see there is we don't have the annex attached. Not because it's any more difficult to put the annex on. In fact, 99% of our customers will never remove their annex. Once it's on, it can stay on. Pack up with it, open back up, and inflate at the same time. The only reason we don't do it, normally we don't have this much space at an expo stand, so in hindsight, we probably should have had here. But anyway, not any harder, just a little bit more time to do. So, all right, the guys are going to go through and do a bit of a setup on there. You'll notice as they go around, anything that you would probably expect it to be relatively heavy has a gas strut on there. So what that means is they're extremely light to be able to go up and over. So, as you can see, Alan did that one-handed. There's really not a lot of weight on there that you need to worry about. So the whole setup process is pretty simple. We put the spare leg down, the spare tire down, and it reveals two of the stabilization legs. The front lid goes over, secures down, the back lid goes over and secures down. And the only other thing you have to do to set this camper up is close off five valves and press a button.
You're welcome to come around. It's pretty uneventful if you close the valves, but there's valves under there.
So there are five valves on this side. If you have the annex attached, which as I said, 99% of our customers can never remove their annex, the annex would sit inside. You can see there, there's a bit of a hole inside there. That's where the annex would sit. You just pull that over, close off more valves on attached to that. So there's a total of five valves on the tent, seven valves on there, total of 12 valves. Once they're done up, you press that button and you sit back and relax. That's the whole setup. Anybody got any questions on that? No? Not a single question on an air inflatable camper trailer. How long does it take to blow up? So, well, you're seeing it right now. So it looks like paint drying for now, but in 3 minutes time it'll be up. So you can go from this to that fully set up in 12 minutes. And by fully set up, I mean the couches are up, the kitchen's out, the fridge is out, ready to go. One of the cool designs of this is while this is all happening, your beer fridge is totally accessible. Very important. So you get your camp chairs out. Oh, by the way, if you buy one of these, which, I mean, by all means, I'm happy to sell one to all of you. Get used to speaking in public, because this is exactly what happens every time you set up an Opus camper in a campsite. Everyone comes and talks to you. So other common questions we get asked, and the logical one with an air inflatable camper is, what happens if you get a puncture or a leak? So the answer, my usual answer, as you would know, is throw the camper out and buy a new one and make more money. But if you don't want to do that, just repair it. It's really, really easy. Each bladder is three stages. There's an internal bladder, which is the one that obviously expands, and then two outer sleeves, which keep it really rigid. You can basically unzip it, put a sticker over it, zip it back up again, and put it back in there. No more than about 10 minutes to repair if in the event you get a puncture. The likelihood of you getting a puncture in here is almost non-existent, except for this lady over here whose husband likes to stab things with knives. So I've already advised her she get a new husband, but it seems like a nice enough guy.
What's warranty?
Warranty has got a 5-year warranty on the body and 3-year warranty on the tent. We are located at Underwood up there, so obviously if you're local and you come up here, and we'd repair it all up there.
Can you make it go faster?
Sorry?
Can you make the air slow and the speed of the air faster or not?
You absolutely can. I would advise you not to. So they're actually calibrated to do the kind of perfect amount. So if you go too fast, there is a risk that you're going to blow things up. That said, we are looking at a two-stage pump to go into these. They're not anywhere near ready, but they'll actually release about 2 or 3 pounds within a couple of seconds, which will get it to almost stand-up point, and then it'll just, a second stage will take over into this sort of format, which will then just pressure it to 7 PSI. That's all it is. I was going to ask a question. Anybody know how much it go up to? I just gave you the answer. Nobody listened, did you? It's just me talking randomly, isn't it? Filling in the space while this does its thing. 7 PSI is what it goes up to.
How does that go in the wind if you're going to set up in the wind?
That's an awesome question. What's it like in the wind? If you want to go over to that one over there, there's a big TV on there. If you stand there long enough, you'll see a video of a helicopter flying 1 meter above it. Fine. I've set it up on Fraser Island where it was absolutely buffeting the thing, and it flapped around while I was doing it, but once it got to 7 PSI, it stopped. Dead still. No problems at all. I would rate this way over a steel pole camper set up in the wind. There you go. So that's now hit 7 PSI. It's shut off, which means you're done. So you get in there, open up the zips, open up the roof to let it all, make sure it's all nice and cool inside there, and away you go. You're off camping. Now the question is, how quickly can we pack it down, right? Because setting up's all good, but it's at the time where you're kind of, you're tired, you're probably hungover, and you've got to get out of the campsite because it's nearly 11 o'clock, right? So you want to get out of there relatively quickly, yeah? All right, so you're going to go from this to fully packed down in 90 seconds. Anybody believe me? Okay, good.
Go.
Somebody did believe me at the last show, and I disappeared.
32,000. Pretty cheap.
So it's literally a matter of, who was it? You wanted to see how fast it goes down? Watch this. Done. Packed up.